Hi guys, my name is Anuj Jindal. Welcome to Morning Tales for 27th August 2019. I've already said on a lot of platforms, social media platforms, because students were waiting for the video on 27th August, the Morning Tales, but I could not make it because I've been severely ill and I'm still not very well. But students need me to at least spare 30 minutes of my time and try and discuss some important things with them on a daily basis. So I thought, let me complete my promise. And so today I'm going to start with a discussion on Sabka Vishwas Legacy Dispute Resolution Scheme, which is a tax resolution scheme. I had said on 26th August that I'll be discussing it, and therefore here I am. And let us talk about it in brief, because this is important not only for your phase 1 but also for your phase 2 of the upcoming RBI and SEBI examinations. Okay, so Ministry of Finance has launched this scheme, and this is going to be operational from 1st September till 31st December. There are two major reliefs that are being provided. Number one, for cases which are in appeal or under adjudication, and number two, for cases where confirmed duty demand has already been made and the person, the people who are in that appeal, have exhausted their appeals. Okay, so for the first category, that is cases which are in appeal, the scheme intends to give 4 month duration to SSEs for settling their legal tax disputes, and they are ready to give 70% off from the duty demand if the amount is up to 50 lakh and 50% off if the amount is over 50 lakh. For confirmed duty demand, if there is no appeal pending, the relief offered is 60% if the duty is up to 50 lakh and 40% if the duty is over 50 lakh. Okay. The primary purpose of this scheme is to close the pending disputes related to legacy service tax and central excise. So, service tax and excise, which have now been subsumed under GST, the purpose is to close all the pending disputes so that the country can smoothly transfer itself towards GST scheme. Okay. So, under it, the SSEs have to voluntarily disclose their due taxes and have to pay the full amount after getting the off that the government is providing, and they will not be facing any legal action. Okay, let's take up the first question for today. I hope you've understood now the Sabka Vishwas scheme. Those are all the facts that are important from the scheme. I will not be discussing a lot of details about the questions that I pick up, but tomorrow I'll try and take the questions in more details. The first question is, who heads the committee formed by Central Vigilance Commission for examining bank frauds of over rupees 50 crore? The answer is A, T.M. Bhasin. So, Central Vigilance Commission has taken up the task of understanding bank frauds of over 50 crore, and T.M. Bhasin is an ex-vigilance commissioner. Which country has felicitated Modi with the King Hamad Order of Renaissance? He was on a trip to Dubai recently, and along with that, he's also visited some neighboring countries, and Bahrain has felicitated PM Modi with this order that they have, with this award that they have. Okay. Who has become the first Indian shuttler? Very important question. So, PV Sindhu has become the first Indian shuttler to win gold at World Championship. Nobody in the past has won gold at a world championship in badminton, and the answer is PV Sindhu. So, very important question this one, I would say, very high chances. What is the new GDP forecast for India for the year 2019 by Moody's Financial Services? These organizations keep revising their forecast, so we have to keep updating our notes again and again. The answer is A, 6.2%. Which country has recorded the highest cases of tiger poaching? The answer is India. So, the Prime Minister recently launched, I believe, a campaign, and at the same time proudly announced that the tiger population has increased by, I think, almost 33% if I'm not wrong. But here is an independent report which says that India has been facing highest cases of tiger poaching. Which state has topped the second edition of Composite Water Management Index? The answer is B, Gujarat. Name of the project launched by Ministry of Textiles to promote sustainable fashion? The answer is A, Su.Re, Please read on this. Very high chances that this is going to be asked in the examination. Which country has recently become the 73rd official non-regional member of Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank? A very important question, this one. I leave it to you guys to answer this question for me because it's a factual question. So you can easily answer this question. Tomorrow I will be taking up some more questions and I will try and discuss them in more details with you so that we don't lose out the momentum that we have created for Morning Tales. Till that time, all the very best. Take care. Please share this video if you like it. Do subscribe to the channel if you learn something new through this video today, especially if you like the explanation, brief explanation on Sabka Vishwas. Okay, take care. Have a nice day.